The use of AI and ChatGPT technologies are revolutionizing the way businesses grow. No longer a secret sauce, it's becoming a key ingredient for increasing efficiency, productivity, and creativity. The true case of working smarter, not harder.
Welcome to the Leverage Business Podcast, where we believe business success is about working smarter, not harder. Leveraging your time and expertise in ways that fit the digital age you and your clients live in today. I'm your host, Jay Allison, author of Leverage Consulting in the Digital Age and founder of the iSuccess Business Academy. And every episode, I'll be sharing insights into how you can apply the power of leverage to grow your consulting, coaching, or other expert services business and create true freedom and independent success with mindset, marketing, and money model breakthroughs. Because when you get leveraged, the sky's the limit. Let's go for it.
Hello and welcome to the Leverage Business Podcast. I'm Jay Allison. Welcome back if you're a regular listener. It's great to connect with you. And today I'm delivering on a topic that's been at the forefront of much discussion in the business and digital arenas, and that, my friends, is artificial intelligence, AI. If you haven't been living under a stone, and I mean that with the utmost respect because it does depend on the work you do and what you read, across both education and business sectors, the field of AI has exploded, and particularly over the last year. Artificial intelligence, or AI, more specifically the new and fast emerging tool ChatGPT and other generative AI tools, has to be one of the most disruptive technologies since social media came on the scene. ChatGPT is exploding. And what is it? Why should we care? And how can we best use it to support our business? That's what we're going to talk about today and in the next couple of episodes. I also want to help those that haven't heard of it, haven't really done anything with it, with how you can get started, even if you haven't even looked at it. I really do encourage you to at least have a play. So type chat.openai.com into your web browser, sign up, free account is fine to begin with, and just experiment asking it to generate stuff for you. So here's why it's important. The business landscape's rapidly evolving, and AI is at the front of this transformation. It offers a myriad of opportunities to harness data, streamline operations, and make data-driven decisions. Whether you're a small consulting firm seeking to optimize client engagements or a solo entrepreneur looking to enhance productivity, AI is your ally in the pursuit of growth and success. So in this three-part mini-series of the podcast, we're going to embark on a journey into the realm of artificial intelligence and its profound impact on small businesses today. Now look, AI is more than just a buzzword, more than the latest fad. It's a strategic imperative for businesses of all sizes. It empowers organizations to tap into the wealth of data at their disposal, extracting valuable insights that drive innovation and competitiveness. From automating routine tasks to offering predictive analytics, AI has the potential to revolutionize the way business is conducted. There's also a huge, huge impact on the production of content, on the writing of copy, and on the creation of courses. We'll talk about that in the later episodes. As we delve into the intricacies of AI in business, keep in mind that this is your gateway to understanding the limitless possibilities that AI presents. The world of entrepreneurship and consulting is on the cusp of a technological revolution. And by embracing AI-driven strategies, you're not only future-proofing your business, but also positioning it for sustained growth and prosperity. In this first episode, we'll unravel the multifaceted world of AI applications, from customer service chatbots to data-driven marketing strategies. Join us as we explore how small businesses are leveraging AI to stay ahead in the ever-changing business landscape. So let's start with the AI revolution? The use of AI and ChatGPT technologies are, as I said, really revolutionizing, and that's not hype, the way that businesses operate, market, and grow. By leveraging these powerful tools, there's potential to substantially increase efficiency, productivity, and profitability to accelerate your business growth. Sound far-fetched? Let's explore what it enables, what are the benefits and challenges, and how to turn the opportunity to your competitive advantage. There may be a lot of hype, but sometimes it's justified. In today's episode, I'm going to attempt to highlight what AI and specifically generative AI tools such as ChatGPT, what they actually enable, and how it's changed the game for many marketers and course creators, for some in a good way and for others in a not so good way. What I want to focus on is what AI and ChatGPT is, what challenges it presents to us as professional, education-oriented service providers, and where's the leverage to be found in using it in your business. Because with the right strategies, businesses can make use of AI-powered tools to maximize their efficiency, profitability, and growth potential. Small to medium-sized businesses can make their operations more efficient by using AI tools and attend to tasks they might not have the time or resources for otherwise. In fact, the topic of AI is likely to pop up all over the business and political landscape because, like it or not, AI technologies and the likes of ChatGPT are not going anywhere. It's something that's going to be integral to our digital world from now on. But it's important to keep in mind that AI is only a tool. It can't replace human expertise, experience, and contribution. Just want to say, AI is actually not new. Back in the 1960s, an MIT computer scientist called Joseph Weizenbaum created ELIZA. You might have heard of it. It's a chatbot that mimicked human-like dialogue. The program shocked users, sparking public interest in the opportunities afforded by artificial intelligence. While ELIZA's capabilities were limited, it did set the groundwork for the current AI revolution. When most individuals are asked about artificial intelligence, they usually approach the topic through the lens of science fiction. They'll talk about Blade Runner, iRobot, Terminator, and other Hollywood-produced parodies. So the concept of AI is not new. In actuality, its significance in our daily lives, beyond what we see in movies or TV, has been generally overlooked or underappreciated. Did you know, for instance, that AI is used in many of the everyday applications we use on our smart devices? It determines the advertisements we see on social media and even follows and predicts our activity across these platforms. So what's new then? What's making us shift our attention over the past year? Well, in particular, it's a new phase of AI known as generative AI, which came to public view with OpenAI's introduction of ChatGPT in November 2022. A large quantity of text data from several sources, such as books, articles, websites, and other textual resources, was used to train ChatGPT, which is an OpenAI chatbot. And it was trained up until September 2021, so pretty recent. It can provide replies and offer information on a broad range of subjects thanks to its training. At the heart of this sharing are algorithms that decide what to display you in your feed or on the website you're viewing. Those algorithms have been fine-tuned throughout time with the express goal of capturing and holding your attention. There's no discernment whether the material is useful or accurate or biased. So let's also just be clear, AI is only machine learning based on this data that it's trained on and algorithms. AI is not sentient. Yet, seriously, just what landed in our world and what it's capable of is staggering. It's surprising and in many ways downright shocking. The fast emergence and growth of ChatGPT is absolutely astounding. And yes, that's a lot of hypey adjectives. And despite being in the technology consulting field, and I'm not one for jumping on any old technology bandwagons, shiny object syndrome has never really been a thing for me. But if you consider it was actually only released to the general public less than a year ago, November 30th, 2022, both its use and its proficiency have already grown exponentially. So if you've been using version 3.5, which was the one that was released, then 4.0 will blow your mind. A plethora of additional generative AI tools emerged in the months that followed ChatGPT's debut, as other software companies scrambled to keep up. So let's kick off with just a few headlines on how to leverage AI and ChatGPT. We're going to explore this in regards to productivity and business growth specifically, but first we need to understand how to use it well and the risks in the marketplace of people using it badly. So how can AI help your business? As I've mentioned, artificial intelligence is quickly progressing, as seen by recent accomplishments like OpenAI's GPT-4 and Midjourney's image generating tool, to mention just two. Emerging AI solutions may automate and assist a wide range of commercial processes, cutting costs and increasing the speed and efficiency with which humans can work, from decision making to data analysis to writing. AI is already being used by large corporations, small to medium-sized organizations, and single entrepreneurs. According to DigitalOcean's May 2023 Currents poll, around 61% of organizations anticipate to boost their use of generative AI machine learning this year. However, before jumping into implementing AI for your business, it's critical to grasp how this technology works, including its benefits and drawbacks. Because while there are many advantages that organizations may receive from implementing AI technology, there are also the concerns that come with incorporating this innovation into your company's arsenal. Artificial intelligence encompasses several disciplines, each of which has its own set of technical procedures. Whether you know about machine learning, deep learning, robotics, automation, the ones that we're probably mostly ourselves going to harness first is natural language processing and generative AI, which have led to the development of sophisticated applications like voice assistants, chatbots, content creation, and language translation. These last two are fast-growing subsets led by OpenAI's ChatGPT, which is already driving much of businesses' content creation. By finding patterns in massive data sets, generative AI, a rapidly expanding type of AI, is excellent at creating digital material, including text, films, music, and photos. AI is the use of machines to perform tasks that typically require human intelligence, such as learning, reasoning, and problem solving. By leveraging AI, you can automate repetitive tasks, gain insights from data that you share with it, and improve decision-making as a result of it. If you're looking to scale your business, you need to consider incorporating AI into your operations. For example, AI-powered chatbots can handle customer inquiries and support, freeing up your staff to focus on more complex tasks. AI can also analyze customer data to identify patterns and preferences, allowing you to tailor your marketing and sales efforts. By implementing AI, you can improve efficiency, reduce costs, and enhance the customer experience. Don't miss out on the opportunity to accelerate your business growth with AI. If you're looking to double your productivity, we're seeing a whole host of use cases in both the education space and business arena. On the one hand, using AI tools like ChatGPT can be equivalent to adding a reasonably competent assistant to your business. On the other hand, the fact that these are tools anyone and everyone can use presents certain obstacles and new challenges too in terms of authenticating content like books and courses. Across this three-part series, I'm going to be sharing some of the use cases we're seeing in relation to key business processes, including marketing and sales, content creation, and online courses. I'm also in the process of finalizing a new book, which is specifically around the AI leveraged business competitive advantage. So I'll be sharing some information for how you can get an early sight of that. I'll be taking you through some of the biggest obstacles for professional educators and expert service providers, and how to tackle them in the age of AI. So let's talk about the AI competitive advantage. In today's fast-paced business environment, companies need to stay ahead of the game to remain competitive. And one way to achieve this is by learning how to leverage the power of AI. As I'm recording this series, I'm in the process, as I said, of finalizing the manuscript for a short monograph to accompany my book, Leverage Consulting in the Digital Age. It's a specific and detailed run-through of both the possibilities and pitfalls of AI, which I hope will help point you to many of the genuine ways small businesses can accelerate their profitability and growth. So if you want an advanced copy and are happy to provide me with feedback and possibly a review when it's published, go to my website, jallison.com, Leverage Business, the AI Advantage, to register your interest. And I will be putting the link to that in the show notes for all of the episodes on this topic. Artificial intelligence provides high-performance technologies that help businesses increase efficiency, save costs, and boost revenue. It's already transforming the corporate environment. According to 2019 McKinsey research, over 63% of the companies questioned reported more revenue and a better return on investment after implementing AI for resource optimization and cost reduction. And that was before ChatGPT was even publicly released. The major business applications of AI range from operations and sales to marketing and customer support, and then more onto content and course building opportunities. AI has the potential to transform the way businesses operate. By automating repetitive tasks, AI can free you up to focus on more strategic work, such as developing new programs and products or improving customer experiences. AI can also help businesses make better decisions by analyzing vast amounts of data and providing insights that humans may miss. This can lead to improved forecasting, better risk management, and increased revenue. Furthermore, AI can help businesses personalize their marketing efforts, improving customer engagement and loyalty. The integration and deployment of these new technologies, as well as the comprehension of the ethical and legal ramifications, provide a number of difficulties and issues when using AI in business. For organizations to properly utilize AI and capitalize on its promise to spur innovation, productivity, and expansion, they must effectively navigate these obstacles. Even the small business owner and solo professional service providers can expect to see major productivity benefits and cost savings from using AI. Working smarter across the whole array of key business operations, AI tools can take the heavy lifting out of much of the work that you do or that your teams perform every day. Some key use cases for AI in business were captured in a recent article by DigitalOcean, which I really like, and I'll put the link in the show notes as well. One, conducting data analysis for predictive sales forecasting. Two, automating tedious administrative tasks. Three, improving customer service and boosting lifetime customer value. Four, upgrading marketing efforts. Five, enhancing cybersecurity and fraud detection. Despite the vast range of possible uses for AI, consultants, coaches, and service providers would do well to employ the technology with focus and caution in order to best suit their own requirements. Forbes recently published an insightful article outlining the various ways you can start to leverage AI for growth and efficiency. I'll put the link in the show notes again. But many of these examples are not really ripe for a small business or solo entrepreneur. So while AI offers significant advantages to the SME small business, leveraging its capabilities is not without challenges. Often a lack of technical capability and comprehension of the field means many business owners find it really hard to know how to integrate AI technologies into current business processes. Certainly one of the challenges. It's also quite challenging for organizations to stay up to date with the newest advancements due to AI's fast developing nature And I'm in the field and I'm really sometimes struggling with the sheer amount of information and best practice and possibilities and tools and all of the options that are coming on stream. Notwithstanding these difficulties, though, the potential benefits of AI really make it worthwhile as a venture to explore. The chance to significantly improve productivity is really too good to miss. So whatever it is that you currently find challenging to do or takes a long time to do, maybe those are some of the areas that you can start with for exploring what ChatGPT and other AI type tools can help you with. Certainly using chatbox might be a particular area to explore if you're looking to improve your responsiveness in terms of customer service. And ultimately, these really should have a return on investment in terms of profitability. So you need to be able to look at whether or not this is leading to more sales, better customer reviews, which lead to more sales, those kind of connections. These are the sort of compelling reasons why firms are engaging on the AI path. I'm going to some of this in a lot more detail in some of the other episodes and in my forthcoming book. So let me give you an example around customer service that I've just mentioned. By setting up an AI chatbot, businesses can improve their customer service by providing instant and personalized responses to inquiries. The hurdles may be effectively addressed with the correct approach and resources, revealing AI's transformational potential. So it's a little bit more of a big step in terms of implementing it, but the payoffs may be quite substantial and immediate. And in fact, that's nothing new. I've been on many people's websites or Facebook groups where there's an immediate chatbot, chat messenger type of automation set up. I mean, this is years ago, so this is nothing new. But really, very few of us, I think, are using it. Maybe we find it a little bit icky or a little bit not quite in keeping with how we like to do business. But the reality is it works and people feel a little bit more supported in terms of how they're interacting with your brand, even though we all know it's not a real human on the other side. So let's go through a few more instant AI use cases for small businesses. Now, I'm not going to do an AI or ChatGPT 101 here. You can look up what AI and ChatGPT is with any Google search. Use Bing, because actually it's got a built-in ChatGPT type of function. And you can find out what other people think and what's happening anywhere on the internet around this area. There's already a plethora of articles and courses teaching the basics, including a vast array of use cases and probably some marketers who are really just trying to get on the bandwagon and tell you that it's going to mean that you can like make a million selling AI generated books or something like that. But what I want to do here is to raise awareness of the potential, the right here, right now, legitimate use cases for how small businesses can immediately start using AI tools. So the first step in getting on board with AI is to identify the specific business needs that AI and tools like ChatGPT might address for you. This involves a thorough requirements gathering process to understand the unique challenges and opportunities within your business where AI can be beneficial. And once you've got defined goals in mind, the AI augmentation that you need will become a lot more obvious, and the time between idea and solution will be a lot shorter. Leveraging AI requires a strategic process that encompasses establishing those business requirements, selecting the appropriate AI technology, deploying it, monitoring and assessing its success, and then growing it. AI and ChatGPT can certainly help reduce the overload of tedious and repetitive tasks. It can generate insights for you by synthesizing a lot of different kinds of information around a subject, and it can create personalized customer experiences, as I've described. And this is really what helps you to do more with less. meaning increase your productivity without increasing your time or spending money on outsourcing or hiring staff. The wild claim to double your business productivity and accelerate business growth is not actually wild. It's something people have been experiencing using these tools. And these are people who are only just starting to play with this. So despite having less resources than larger corporations, small businesses may get the AI advantage because they're able to expand their operations by leveraging these tools to do more in less time, pretty much for free. From automating expenditure management to creating sales copy to creating inventive artwork from text. Given that small businesses are still in the early stages of adopting generative AI, it would be advantageous to use the technology sooner rather than later so you get the competitive edge. And if by using these tools, you can speed up many of the tasks that you do yourself, personally or across a team, then it's like outsourcing, but it frees you up to do the high revenue focused activities that only you as the expert can do. But it also means that you can get some of the heavy lifting taken out of the tasks that you're already doing. So you're not staring at that blank piece of paper, for example, or you're not spending time trying to analyze a whole load of different things to work out what is the key message. Imagine you can program a tool to do things that you can do, but would take you hours. What about things you're actually not very fast at or lack good skills to do? Here's some quick examples before we get into everything. What if we could ask ChatGPT to give us a list of target companies that meet certain criteria? What if we then ask it to give us some market research information on those companies, what they value, who their customers are, and so on? We can really use it to help build out our ideal client avatar. How about ideas, outlining, even drafting? You avoid staring at that empty page, as I said, desperately hoping for inspiration to come, because with ChatGPT, you can actually make a start. You ask it to give you 10 ideas. You ask it to write outline content for those ideas. And then you build out each section of what it comes back with. You can use this to create sales pages, email sequences, heck, even write a whole book. But do it in stages. So now you need only spend your time or paid copywriter's time refining and restructuring, putting on the finishing touches that makes it truly your final voice and creation. How much time and money might this save you? And what if we use the power of AI to ask ChatGPT to suggest topics for a course that fits the needs of our ideal client? So we start by giving it some context about our ideal client and about the topic, asking it for ideas around topics that would really be valuable to this audience. What if we then continue and ask it to suggest a curriculum outline for that course? What if we ask it to suggest lesson plans, write a video script for each lesson? We'd have done a whole ton of things that would otherwise take us or our team hours, even days, to design and script. What if you could use an AI-driven image generator to create realistic pictures from your requirements via text commands? You could avoid spending hours hunting out stock photos or icons. These are just some of the things my team and I have been playing around with, and we're just getting started. Similar to how students know not to recite Cliff's Notes, Cole's Notes, on a test, businesses should not rely solely on AI output, but rather use that output to get more productive, more creative, and work smarter. If we can use AI and ChatGPT for the initial research, outlining, and drafting, we increase our capacity without hiring any staff. How does the idea appeal to you, using a tool to cut out a lot of the legwork of tasks we spend hours on in our business? So far, our wild claim is mostly about speed, efficiency, volume. I have to say it's harder to find good use cases in terms of delivery, if you're only delivering everything one-to-one for clients, for example. But if you take on some of the leveraged business models I work on with my clients, and we talk about this in the podcast, AI-driven ChatGPT and other tools offer up a gigantic opportunity to increase your reach and revenue through content, copy, and course creation. Transitioning your service model to more leveraged and hybrid approaches is something I talk about in more depth in my book, Leveraged Consulting in the Digital Age, where Chapter 6 looks at leveraged delivery to enable growth and scaling through online and blended programs. So we covered a fair amount of ground and still really only touched the surface. Nonetheless, I hope it gave you insights and what to go explore further that relate to how you run your business. Next time in part two, I'm going to share how ChatGPT can help you boost your business marketing, sales, and revenue. And then in part three, we'll dive into AI-powered course building. So don't forget to subscribe to the show, the Leveraged Business Podcast, so you can get alerted when the next episode drops. And if you want more, as I said, I'm finalizing the manuscript for this short monograph to accompany my book that's going to address possibilities and pitfalls of AI. And I'm tentatively calling it the AI Advantage. And I hope this is going to help point you to many of the genuine ways you can leverage AI to accelerate your business's profitability. And if you'd like an advanced copy and are happy to provide me with feedback, possibly a review when it's published, then go to jallison.com/leveragedbusiness/the-AI-advantage to register your interest. And I'll pop that link into the show notes for the episode. So I will see you and talk to you again soon. Ciao, ciao for now. Thank you for listening to the Leveraged Business Podcast. Want to create leverage in your business? Did this episode provide some insights and ideas to be thinking through? If so, subscribe so you get alerts when the next one's released. If you want to learn more or would like help and support with building a leveraged business that achieves true freedom for you, then head over to jallison.com/podcast to find all the resources and links that go with this show on my website and to join our iSuccess community. And if you're enjoying our content, it would be great if you could pop into Apple Podcasts or the app you listen from and leave me a rating and review. Everyone makes a difference to improving our rankings. So thank you if you've done that already. I appreciate you. So hey, that's it. Thank you for listening. I hope you've loved this episode and have some great takeaways to be thinking through. I wish you a pleasant, productive, and profitable week. And I'll see you again next time for another episode of the Leveraged Business Podcast.